3, 2, 1. Welcome to Covino and Rich.
And tonight, well, we're gonna wing it.
Yep, hang.
Welcome to Popcorn Talk, featuring movie discussion, news, and interviews. Popcorn Talk, we talk movies. And now, here's Popcorn Talk's Covino and Rich.
Wow.
Whipping it new.
Another Thursday night.
Cheers, pals.
Cheers, all right.
Cheers, big ears.
Hanging out.
Hey.
Time to lounge. The weekend begins now. What's up? That's Spotty, our radio
producer.
Hi, Spotty.
We are Covino and Rich. Welcome to Popcorn Talk. We'll talk a little movies after we, you know, get into it.
We're really winging it, so.
Tommy, like wingy.
I don't even know what you want to get through
today. We're winging it like the band Winger. Stewart's favorite band.
Winger. Right?
Wasn't that Stewart's favorite band in Beavis and Butthead?
Stewart loves Winger.
Right, Spot?
Wasn't
you? Yeah. Didn't you wear the Winger t-shirt? Todd was the coolest guy.
You loved Beavis and Butthead. On a throwback Thursday, Covino's the guy. Listen, we all loved Beavis and Butthead. We all thought there was something to be said.
I was a Beavis guy. That's why I always sit this way. You only see the side of my face.
That,
yeah.
But you were the guy.
I'm like, weird.
You were the guy that loved them. Everyone else liked them.
Loved them. From the Liquid Television days, loved them, still do. Anyway, we hope you love our show. If you don't know us, we're on Sirius XM for the past 11 plus years, Monday through Friday mornings on Rush 93 from the West Coast.
Yep.
We do this Thursday nights. We had an action-packed week so far. We had Joe Coy, T.O., Pete Yorn, Damon John from Shark Tank, and if you missed any of it, catch it on demand, Sirius XM. Tomorrow we got Ben Falcone.
Very funny guy. It's actually Melissa McCarthy's husband who wrote the movie The Boss, which is out this weekend.
Comes out this weekend. We'll talk about it later, but we got lots of stuff to talk about. Everything from relationships.
Let's hear it.
To entertainment.
Let's hear it.
To, you know, reminiscing a little bit about some movies.
Oh.
But a question first. Just like a rando question.
Rando?
Go ahead. Yeah, rando Calrissian. You guys want to chime in at home. You want to chime in? We are taking text messages. We are live. 412, the letter CNR show. That's our text message. I got the computer right here. I'll pull it up. 412, the letter CNR show.
I can't see it. Where is it?
So we always talk about next level relationships, right?
Yeah.
Basically, it goes like this. If you make a new friendship or a relationship in today's world.
As an adult,
it's unlikely that you'll call the guy, right?
So if you don't meet someone new and start chit-chatting.
You meet Carl at the gym and you realize you guys have stuff in common, right?
Carl.
There's a good chance you might meet for drinks.
Carl.
You might hang out here and there.
Have some pudding with Carl.
You might go have some pudding.
On
you
a
might
roof.
Go chase some ass and ask gays and hang out here and there and shoot some hoop. But you know what you probably won't do? You probably won't call up Carl and be like, yo, Carl. So I've been thinking, man, about life. It won't happen.
No.
Those are conversations reserved for your childhood buds.
Yeah, people you've known your whole life.
Right.
The guy that you played wiffle ball with, that you knocked on his door and asked his mom, yeah, could Chris come out and play?
Right.
That's the guy you will probably still talk to every few months on the phone.
If you have those conversations in a newer friendship, that means your friendship has gone to newer heights
way quick.
Quicker than most relationships do in today's world, right?
Yeah.
So I have a question based on that theory and that mindset. Mm-hmm. What about the whole Snapchat world of things?
Ooh.
Because I got to admit,
this is a good question.
There's only a few people that I send personal snaps to.
Now, sending a personal Snapchat,
right?
It's not like texting.
Mm.
It's not calling. It's not FaceTiming.
No.
But you're going out of your way to be like, all right, let me find a funny filter. Oh, I'll be the Pee Wee Herman or the Mona Lisa, which is big this week, right?
It's not Pee Wee. It's actually Mona Lisa. It's not Pee Wee.
But it looks like Pee Wee Herman.
Wait, it has nothing to do with Pee Wee Herman.
You look like Pee Wee Herman when you do it.
It gives you the Pee Wee nose.
No, it has nothing to do with Pee Wee Herman.
But you look like anyone looks like Pee Wee Herman doing
it. No, we said you look like Pee Wee Herman.
You plus Mona Lisa equals Pee Wee Herman.
Yeah,
that's what it comes down to.
So
or the dog one where you stick out your tongue and the dog tongue comes out,
which is lame, but everybody loves that one for whatever reason. But anyway, the point is, I don't really even use Snapchat, right? I use it to check up on our own. You could find us on Covino and Rich on Snapchat, but I use it to see our own, to see what's there, to check out my wife. She's in Japan this week and see what
and
she's up to.
I know you're doing it just because you want to monitor what Spot Snapchat.
Right, yeah.
Because exactly. Spot operates our Snapchat for the show, like you said, Covino and Rich.
I follow a few colleagues like Maria Menounos who allows us to do this show. Thank you, Kevin and Maria. But a few of our friends that listen to our show hit us up, like Drew Mack from Nashville,
a
guy that we know through the show who's become a friend. And he has sent me personal snaps of him like, as a panda.
Whoa.
Yeah, not as Don.
As a panda?
Whoa.
As a panda?
Not like a naked man panda, just like being stupid.
Amanda.
Yeah.
Amanda.
Duh. Yeah, no, you know what I'm talking about. The filters that they provide.
Drew Mack sent you him as
he
a panda?
Sent me a few of
what'd
them,
he say?
Right? Nothing, just he's pretending to be a panda. I don't know what the fuck he's doing, right? So,
you guys, your relationship's at a new height.
Oh, because I thought it was funny. So then I was like, all right, well, you know, I'll send one back. I wasn't a panda, but I'll do something dumb. I'll put on some filter and I... Yeah.
Oh, look.
And
look,
I become...
I'm a panda.
I'm a panda.
Or I'll put on a stupid filter with my stretched out head or something and become a character. So I've sent him snaps back. Now, Drew Mack, we know, is a friend.
Yeah.
We've met him. But is that next level sort of friendship behavior?
Because yeah, I think
I've
it is.
I've sent Drew Mack snaps, but I haven't sent my, like, childhood bud snaps.
Yeah, you haven't sent me snaps.
I haven't. No, I have.
Oh, you sent me one.
I have. I just started. It's a new world for me. But is it like new level friendship things that
you know what I
like you don't do?
Well, I think you and Drew Mack are. I don't think many of the guys you went to high school with are on Snapchat.
Well, that's the thing.
Here's the point. Drew Mack, you found another guy that lives like a 20-year-old girl.
No, well, here's
so the, so you decide to start snapping each other.
You know, the things you'll do with your old school friends, you won't do in how do I say this? Your new friends, you'll do the new technology and experience new things with. But you probably won't experience that with your old friends.
That's fair enough.
Is that a
decent theory? I agree.
So it doesn't mean I'm weird or anything, right? You guys... Mm-mm. Okay, cool. Just making sure.
But I do think it's funny that you're Snapchatting panda shots.
You haven't done that?
I've not.
You put way more effort into your Snapchat than you do anything else.
What does that mean? In what way? Oh, you mean like...
In life.
Like life.
Oh, really? Is it really?
Your Snapchat's
I'm not even active on it.
Oh, it seems like you try pretty hard to impress Drew Mack.
No, but you're impressing Drew Mack, you do like voices, you do cool
Is that
filters.
Really effort? That's what everybody does, though. You can pick a voice and character.
You're playing your Snapchats more than you did the show tonight.
Oh, yeah, well, like I said, we winging it tonight. Man.
Yeah, this is total wingy, like Tommy-like wingy.
No, there's a lot of things to get through. The first thing was, though, you know, is Snapchat the current day friendship.
Is it a new type of
experience?
Friendship? Do you have a Snapchat pal that you don't actually even hang out, but it's the type of person that you'll send funny shit to?
Right. Look, let's be honest. You know, millennials and kids with barely any pubes were on Snapchat for a long time, sending nudie shots and shit like that. We got on it because of our show, about 6 months ago?
Yeah.
Maybe more than that?
No,
nine months ago?
I've had it for a while, but I just actively started using it.
I started to use it recently as a result, and, you know, I'm like, all right, is this weird? Is it lame to do this? It feels a little creepy in a way. You know what I mean? I'm not used to it.
Why? What's creepy about it?
It disappears when you're done with it?
Is it creepy because you feel a little weird? Like, what are you doing? It's really just sending photos.
Is it crazy because you are actually sending dong shots to Drew Mack?
No, it is. You don't think that's odd? You don't think that's odd for you to be sending like videos to like random people? I'm not saying Drew Mack's random.
Well,
you did
face swap with you and your penis, right?
it doesn't work. I tried. So I think that's just the current.
Sorry,
day.
Drew Mack. Didn't work.
He probably has tried.
But Drew Mack sends good Snapchats. It's funny, man. So anyway, I want to say that. That's today's current day next level, yo, bro, what's up, sort of thing, I think. I'm not sure. I don't know.
Yo, bro, I'm a panda.
Yeah. I'm a panda.
Check me out, panda boy.
Yeah. All right, it's dumb, but it's just something to think about because that's the world we live in now. Woo. The other thing is, you know, and by the way, Drew Mack sends me a snap as we speak. Look at that. He must be watching live. So Drew Mack's watching live. Uncle Bill's watching live.
Oh, what's up, Uncle Bill?
Hey, there's Drew Mack. Look at that.
Rubbing himself with a beard?
He's creepy!
Yeah, see?
That's really creepy.
My brother sent me one too. All right. Okay. Well, anyway, thank you guys for hanging out. Follow us, all of us, at Covino and Rich on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, Covino and Rich. And social media is Covino and Rich Show, Facebook, right?
Gotcha.
Facebook, Covino and Rich
Correct
Show.
Correct the mundo.
All right, well, speaking of the world we live in now, right? And because this is popcorn talk, I figure we reminisce on a Throwback Thursday.
Well, there's a movie.
A movie that's near and dear, I think, to everyone's heart. I think it's the most recent current day classic that I know of.
Well, in the world of sports movies, if you want to categorize a few things, that you can put this in the top five of kids movies and also the top five of sports movies. And I don't know many other movies you could do that with. Maybe Mighty Ducks. What's another good kids movie that's also a sports movie? We're talking about The Sandlot.
Okay.
Turns 23 today.
Hey, yeah.
I feel like Sandlot.
I've liked that movie forever. Hold on, I'm gonna Snapchat to Drew Mack for a moment.
Are you gonna do this the whole show?
Yeah, I hope so. I sure hope.
Sorry. Hold on. I'll do it later.
What was that?
No, anyway.
Cute talk.
This movie, in my opinion, one of the most current day classic kid movies.
Yeah, of course.
That come to mind for me.
When you think of this,
23 years old, dude.
You know, I had one problem with this movie. One problem. I know. Benny the Jet Rodriguez, when he got older, he had a mustache.
Yeah,
but, and it made him so uncool.
By the way, there's a story to it, though.
Would that be current? The flash forward? Like, what year did that take place?
Oh. No.
No, he would be way younger because he was in the major leagues. He'd be like 20-something.
All right, but get this. Yeah. Here's the backstory on that. The kid that played Benny the Jet Rodriguez, right? They casted his actual older brother to be him in that movie. So you wonder, well, who's that guy? Why'd they pick that guy with the stache, right?
It's his older brother.
It's his older brother, and he points up.
He's at Benny. He's like stealing third. He's on third base or something.
The sad part of the story is that guy, his brother, actually died.
Oh.
Yeah. Sorry, just saying.
Negative Norberto.
Sorry, jeez.
Maybe Drew Mack will send you a sympathy Snapchat.
Didn't mean to bring down the mood.
And didn't the guy who played Benny the Jet, didn't he get in like some recent legal trouble, like a bar brawl?
No.
Did he almost kill someone?
Is this going to turn into the Different Strokes family or what?
No, but you always see, things online.
How's Ham? Is he okay?
He's ugly as ever, I'm sure.
Oh, and by the way, the other thing that annoys me,
he's a ginger?
How You're Killing Me Smalls has become an overused like t-shirt slogan.
Yeah.
And like,
do you get residuals on that? That was you, right? Or no, that wasn't you.
That was not me.
No, you look like Squints. That kid Squints.
Yeah, that's me.
That's
Squints.
That was Rich.
No, but you don't think You're Killing Me Smalls has? It wasn't overused when the movie came out, but it's almost like the throwback Target T-shirt that you see like bozos wearing.
So as we celebrate this classic film, right? A lot of quotable lines. You play baseball like a girl, right? Forever and
the
Wendy
dog
Peppercorn,
and Babe Ruth ball, everything.
Right. So many memorable moments.
By the way, Wendy Pfeffercorn, got to be in the, if you want to be listy today, definitely top five movie or TV crush, right? The hot lifeguard?
Yeah.
CPR, the whole deal?
I mean, in the movie, yeah, for sure.
I mean, come
top
on.
Top five?
And she gave you a little sweatpan boner?
Yeah, well,
then?
I mean,
really?
It's like, I mean, well, think about it. Nicole Eggert, Charles in Charge.
Yeah.
Alyssa Milano, who's the boss?
Samantha.
Maybe some Carmen Electra, Pam Anderson, but they weren't really in movies or TV shows. They were just more pinup girls.
Right.
Who else comes to mind? Wendy Pfeffercorn.
Who comes to
maybe,
mind?
Maybe Winnie Cooper?
Yeah, for sure.
Winnie Cooper's on that list?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, she was cute.
But you can't say that. I mean, Wendy Pfeffercorn's on this list.
I don't remember. See, I was a little bit older, but I still appreciated the movie.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I was already past.
Well,
didn't
you appreciate the Squints' move by pretending he was he had drowned?
For sure. But as we reminisce, and we'll think of some other iconic sweatpants boner nominees. We'll get
all right,
to those.
Fair enough.
I wanted to read something.
Amanda Beckett from Can't Hardly Wait.
Oh,
good one.
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
That's it. That's the number one
answer. When she walks in with her,
there is no hotter girl that personified that hot.
Her boobs
teenage
walked in. And then she walked in behind.
By the way, when they said, who's going to want you now? I'm thinking, like, everybody?
This guy. Hello.
We're like, nobody.
Come on, Spot. Do it.
We're like, nobody.
He does it good. Does it good.
Wow, right. You really got me there.
So as we reminisce Throwback Thursday and we pay our respects to this movie, I want to bring the mood down again and get your thoughts on this. I don't know who this guy is, but I saw him on my Facebook page. And he says,
what's his name? Give him props.
Matt Lyle. But an old friend of mine actually reposted him.
Okay.
So shout out to my old pal Rich Raymond, who I used to play Little League with.
Gotcha.
It says, RIP The Sandlot. Today on the bus, we watched a movie, The Sandlot. A movie I've seen at least 100 times over the years.
Today on the bus? What bus is he taking?
The autobus.
I mean,
but
this guy took a bus when we lived in New York.
Yeah, as I've gotten older.
Today on the bus, I realized I should be working harder. I'm sorry, continue.
Maybe he was...
I
don't know.
Some people take the bus.
What?
Maybe it was a school trip or
today
something.
Today on the bus, I realized things are not working out as planned.
Maybe the kids were... Yeah, I have no idea.
Unless you're in the New York area and you're taking mass transit because it's in Manhattan.
Or you're trying to disarm a bomb and your name is Keanu Reeves.
Yes, there's few reasons you want to be on a bus.
What I'm about to read isn't the most profound thing ever. We've thought about it and we've talked about it on our show, but I want to see if this holds true to you still.
Okay.
All right, so he goes, on the bus... Watched the movie 100 times over the years, But as I've gotten older, I've watched it through a much different lens, and today, instead of laughing and enjoying it like I usually do, sadness was the general feeling.
Sadness!
Sorry! Just seeing.
Another sad story.
You see, when someone my age watches The Sandlot, we experience it different than kids nowadays, and that's what makes me sad. My youth parallels The Sandlot story is almost too much. Every day when the neighborhood kids would go home from school, and during summer vacation, we would all congregate out in the court and play until the streetlights came on. We played baseball, football, street hockey, basketball, you name it, we did it. My favorite youth memories weren't family vacations or anything I ever saw on screen. My favorite memories as a kid were a group of us playing wiffle ball in my backyard.
Yeah.
The strike zone was taped to the sliding glass door, and my dad had painted foul poles in the backyard fences. In 2016, a majority of youth are consumed by screen time and organized athletics, and will never get to experience what the movie The Sandlot truly embodies. The landscape of America's neighborhoods and athletics has changed, and we say rest in peace to the likes of Benny the Jet, the Great Hambino, Smalls, and the rest of the gang. America, you're killing me, Smalls, as you hate. Yeah. It's kind of a bummer, right? But it's Sorry!
Just saying!
Negative Norberto. No, but it's true.
I know.
I don't mean to be negative Norberto, but can today's youth really look at that and relate to it?
No, like, they can. That doesn't sound like
what
grumpy.
What movie was that set in, though? What year, what generation was that movie set
in? Well, A Babe Ruth Baseball was accessible, so I'm guessing 50s or 60s, maybe.
Spot, can you look that up?
70s? I'm looking it up right
because
now.
Wendy, Peppercorn was like very 60s or 70s hot, I think.
Okay, so let's say it was the 60s, right?
60s. Okay. Early 60s.
Our childhood, growing up in the 80s, 90s,
yeah.
Right? We could still relate to that.
Well, because
that
you still,
lifestyle
you
that
still
they were portraying.
Played outside. I mean, much had changed, but not much
not
had changed.
Not that much.
Think about it.
Now watches that and they're like, what fucking century was this from?
I'm not breaking the glass on anything here, but computers and phones. That was the real game changer.
Yeah.
I mean, a kid growing up with cell phones and computers and stuff like that, that's the game changer. Your parents grew up different than we did.
Yeah, but that is sad that they'll never experience that.
No, of course not.
Late night game of even hide and seek because they're just doing stupid shit on Snapchat all the time.
Hide and seek, is that a Xbox or PS?
As I've said on the radio show, if we were young now, we'd be doing the same thing. We'd be Snapchatting, we'd be Instagramming, and we would not be going outside. You could almost say, hey, you feel sort of lucky that you grew up in that decade.
Don't you feel like their memories suck in comparison to what we at least...
Well, they won't know anything. You don't know what never happened to you.
Another deeper thought.
What's
then,
the
Rich?
Old phrase? You don't know what you don't know? That's not the phrase. What is it?
What you don't know sure can't hurt you.
Yeah, that's it.
And what you can't see makes you scream.
Why do you play air guitar with a pick?
Because I use a pick.
He uses a pick when he plays.
Twisted Sister, bro. Yeah. What you don't know can't hurt you, I guess.
CNR picks. He uses CNR picks.
Think of this. Your parents raised you, right? And probably took a little bit of...
Some people say wolves raised me.
they probably appreciated the fact that you were able to have a similar upbringing to their own.
Yeah.
We don't have that. Listen, we're not going to have that same feeling.
We had an updated version of our parents' upbringing.
Right.
Our kids' generation has a completely different...
Right? But there was an understanding there.
Yeah.
When our kids are in that phase, they're like... You don't understand, Dad! Because, you know what?
We won't.
We won't, because we didn't grow up that way.
You know what? I will say that I don't... See, the thing is, you don't know what's going on unless you're in that scene. Meaning, I don't know what cartoons are popular. Guess what I don't
Teen
have?
Teen Titans.
I don't have a kid.
Steven's Universe.
Yeah, so you know you got a kid.
The Amazing World of Gumball.
So, I don't know if teenagers are riding bikes around town. Because guess who I don't hang out with? Teens. So are 13, 14, 15-year-old kids riding around town on bikes and playing sports? I don't know.
You just wank off to them on Pornhub.
That's a fucking weird thing to say.
That's really inappropriate.
What? I say, what?
Child porn?
Teens?
What the fuck is wrong with you? What a sicko. Who is this guy?
That's disgusting.
I didn't mean like little kids, you fucking weirdo.
I said 13, 14, 15-year-olds riding around on
teens,
bikes.
You asshole.
No. And you jerk off to them, Rich.
Jesus. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
This guy's a fucking...
Oh, my God. Dude, get out of here.
Oh my Beat God. It. Have I know, some class. I know.
Yeah, okay. At least say the proper term, barely legal.
Let's see. Okay, ready?
Jesus
Checking the show
God.
Live for the first time. Loving it so far. Curtis from Cali.
Hey.
Oh, Curtis.
Hey, Curtis. Thank you for hanging out with us.
Actually, text I might have an update about Curtis and Callie, so hang out.
Curtis is about to get a surprise.
The letter C in our show. 412, the letter C in our show. People saying they enjoyed our Damon John interview this week. Again, hear that on demand on Sirius XM. Younger guys say Topanga from Boy Meets World.
Oh, yeah. No, that was an absolute crush for a lot of guys as a kid. But back to what I was saying before you said your completely inappropriate teen sex comment.
Oh, bro. Like, you've never seen those options. No one said they were little kids in junior high.
That's what I said, and you said that.
Don't beat it,
anyway,
dude.
I was asking you, I don't know because it's not a scene. I don't live in a neighborhood with young kids running around. Do kids still ride bikes around the neighborhood?
Depends what neighborhood.
Think about
you're
what
in.
Was important to you.
Some this, neighborhoods you'll see no trick or treaters, and in other neighborhoods it's like a scene from E.T.
Spot, you know what? This sounds very old guy of me. Covino sounds old, and I hate to ever sound that way. But
Covino does it all the time.
I know, but I just wondered when you were a kid, getting that Mongoose or Huffy or 10-speed or mountain bike, those are big deals for you. Getting a bike, the right bike, was a big deal.
You had a Kent.
I had the worst bike, but I'm just saying, do kids now even care? Is that not even a concern? Is that even a concern at all?
I don't know. The GT Performer, that was the shit.
Yeah, but are kids now concerned?
I don't know. I don't think so. I really don't. As sad as that is. Not to bring down the vibe, but as we reminisce and we pay tribute to this movie,
I got the answer.
23 years old
I got
today,
the answer.
It does make you think about it.
The equivalent of a kid riding around on a dope bike around the neighborhood?
Yeah.
It's a kid circling his kitchen on a hoverboard.
Yeah, I'd say so.
What a sad reality that is.
Do they put pegs on the hoverboard to travel?
Carry their friends?
You, travel with their friends?
You, to keep a long story short, have a teenage kid living at your house.
Yeah.
And you say that he goes from his room to the kitchen back to his room on a hoverboard.
Yeah, he's future boy.
He's future boy. That's the extent of his physical activity. He can't even walk around the house anymore.
Future boy.
Future.
You know what? I love the Future Brothers, bro. Future Brothers.
I don't know who they are.
What do you mean? Black dudes in the locker room after the football games?
Driving around on hoverboards.
When you see you see these girls like doing coverage at the football game, and then you see these
I'm
guys.
Rebecca Johnson, ESPN.
And you see like dudes like
you see Future Brother in the background. Yo, where's my Jamie?
All the time.
Future boys. Future Brothers.
He has another one of those things for his penis.
It's a little cradle.
You ever notice that? Well, anyway, as we pay tribute, those are some of the takeaways when I think back of the parallels, like this guy was talking about our childhood and something that took place in the 60s and how much it changed from when we grew up to now.
Yeah.
It must be such an unrelatable movie to a kid today.
Think about one last thing, to define the difference between the generations. What was your parents' biggest fear and your biggest fear when you were a kid? It was getting abducted by the white van.
Yeah, I was just going to say that.
Are you serious?
The guy in the white van.
Yeah, there was always like, who's kidnapping who? Yeah. It was the kidnappers of the white van.
Did you have to worry about the brown van?
I don't know what that means.
Okay, I guess we worried about the white van.
We worried about the white van.
The brown van. Get it?
Get it?
Good one.
Mexican not really, joke.
No, but it was the
Mexican
white van, joke. And maybe like kidnapped.
What do you mean not really?
Kidnapped or... I don't know. What was really the big concern? Your parents' concern?
Everyone had a crazy lady in her town, like Crazy Mary
or
something?
Yeah, like your parents like,
Crazy Mary on the boulevard.
Don't do drugs. Nancy Reagan said so. Now...
Oh yeah, people were slipping razor blades
Your Halloween candy. Now you're a handful of years away.
Yeah.
From being concerned about what your daughter finds on the internet.
Oh man, it is
a concern it's that our parents never had.
It's an innocence killer.
When you were a kid, the innocence of getting your first nudie magazine.
Do you remember your first the moment when your innocence was ruined?
Yeah, I remember. I bought my buddy Phil and I bought a. It was a nudie magazine called Club. Club magazine?
Film my ball sack?
Yeah, film my ball sack.
Yeah, right.
You remember Club magazine?
Club magazine.
It was not Playboy, not Penthouse. It was a nudie magazine.
Yeah.
We bought one at the local little convenience store. But I was 16, 15 or something. And the thing was is that you had to be ballsy enough to try to buy it yourself or ask someone else to buy it for you.
Yeah.
There was an innocence to your...
You bought it yourself?
Yeah. But I didn't. I got to give Phil credit. Yeah. You know how I know? Because he got to keep the magazine, and there's like a little insert in the magazine that I got to keep.
So you got to keep the
like the little ad.
Out.
But the ad had, it was like a little book of ads, but all the ads had naked girls on it.
Oh, that's funny.
But there was something innocent and truthfully not that bad about that, right? It was like, hey, it was a teenage boy trying to see a naked girl.
Yeah.
Now, but again, you were 10-year-old,
yeah.
a 10-year-old, 11-year-old that's like just going online to look at a cartoon or something, or like something, you know, a toy.
So basically,
she could stumble upon porn.
There was something innocent. There's an innocence lost.
Yeah.
That was still around in the 60s, that was depicted in this movie, that mm-hmm. we were still able to experience in the 80s, not even 90s, that is completely, let's just say for
90% lost.
To be positive.
Yeah. 90% lost.
Not completely lost, but maybe 90% lost because of things that we lived through. The internet and social media and things like that.
For happy birthday, Sandlot.
Yeah, we always say it. For every awesome thing that you gain through technology, you lose something else. And, you know, we mm-hmm. lost a lot of that innocence and a lot of that fun we had growing up.
I gotcha.
Hey, things change. And like I said, like you said, what they don't know basically can't hurt them.
Yeah, but you don't know. What was
your favorite part of the movie to wrap it up?
Sandlot?
Yeah. Spot.
Ooh.
You remember? I always like the narration, right? That sort of thing is always cool.
Yeah.
That's why I always like things going up, like the Christmas story.
I like their attempts to get the ball back from the dog.
I mean, that was the movie.
Yeah, but I feel like some of their attempts when they were like trying to figure out contraptions to get the ball.
I like James Earl Jones.
James Earl Jones?
James Earl Jones.
Wasn't he in another baseball movie?
Yeah, Field of Dreams.
Oh, Field of Dreams. Yeah, that's right. All right, so that's another list.
Yeah.
Top baseball movies.
For
top
another
chicks
day.
Growing up for another day. Sandlot, maybe you'll see it this weekend, played over and over again because it's the anniversary of the
exactly.
movie. All right, so let me get more feedback. Jamie hits us up. JetBlue Jamie Manos says, enjoying Thursday Night Live. Fellas, we are live.
Well, 412, thank you guys.
The letter C
thank
in our
you, ladies.
Show. 412, letter C in our show. Topanga was and still is totally bangable. That's from the Ass Man.
Check
us out from Binghamton, New York. And we've had Topanga on our
Binghamton
talk show. She's a lot of fun.
Right, just south of Syracuse.
Is it?
Binghamton, New York.
All right.
Binghamton, New York is where my college, my high school sweetheart dumped me.
Tell us about it.
I went to go visit her at Binghamton.
And?
She was with another dude.
Really?
Yeah. I knocked on the door.
Oh, you told me the story. You didn't have like a gift from K Jewelers?
I bought her a necklace from K Jewelers. She sent me on my way. Sad times.
And what happened? That was it? The guy gave
me a wedgie. Some guy opened the door, and he's like, yeah, could I help you?
You know what's funny? This makes me think of an encounter I had. We're going to talk about relationships. If you don't know, on Covino and Rich, we talk often about relationships. On Thursdays like today, we like to reminisce a little bit and throw it back.
Yeah.
But I had an encounter with an ex-girlfriend one time. It was almost a forced encounter. Like,
knew she was going to be somewhere.
I had an inkling she was going to be there. I was hoping to see her to reconnect.
Like, oh, it's weird seeing you here. But I knew you were going to be here.
Yeah, and the story goes like this. And I was going to talk about this anyway because I feel like Sylvester Stallone had a weird encounter based on his Instagram today.
Yeah. Steve, whoever, look at this picture.
Stallone
insinuates that this was a accidental meetup. And
he,
to me...
He doesn't insinuate. He basically says it. If you read the caption there, he says something about... He ran into Dolph Lundgren at lunch.
How does Drago and Rocky Balboa...
Can you imagine this being there, eating lunch, minding your business? You're like, I could swear that's Ivan Drago. that's Ivan Drago.
And then all of a sudden you turn, you're like... That's Stallone. And all of a sudden they're like, yo, like, what's up?
I can't believe it.
Like, I saw you a long time ago,
okay,
and now we see each other again.
I want to find what he says. Spot, do you have it there? Can you read that?
Yeah, it's right up on the
thing. Okay, ready? He goes, ran into Dolph Lundgren at lunch. And no, we did not fight over the check or have a rematch. Now, okay, maybe he just worded
it
that way.
The same place?
I mean, is it that much of a coincidence?
I guess it could be.
So anyway, was that a forced encounter? Was it just a random coincidence? Is he misleading us to think that? I don't know. Possibly.
Possible.
But I'll never forget, I knew this girlfriend who left me at the time was going to be at this Jersey club. Like this real Guido club, dude.
Hunka Bunka?
No, it was the one at the
Knuckleheads?
Jersey Shore. No.
DJs in Belmar?
Knuckleheads was good, though. Isn't that where Spot's brother works? Guido Robot?
Yeah.
Guido Robot.
Guidotron.
Guidotron? Spot, what was that place? Like Apple, something Apple. Something, I'm picturing Apple or Cherry. Seaside Heights, right on the strip.
Jenks is the only one I know. Jenkinson's?
No, I'm talking Seaside. That's Point Pleasant.
Oh, Point Pleasant? I don't know.
If you guys don't know, we're East Coast guys from New Jersey, Long Island, Spot's from New Jersey. So... I remember going to this really Guido Jersey club because I knew the girl I was dating was going to be there, and we had just broken up recently.
Yeah.
And I was going to force this encounter, and I was all, like, you know, serious about it. Like,
I want you back!
I'm just going to have this moment.
What are we going to say? No, like, it's destiny. I want you back!
She's not going to turn me down. You know, I was like, when I see her, things will change. And I went there, and the whole time you're doing the lurk, you're like,
where is she?
I think I see her.
There she is.
Right? Yeah, you're looking around. You know that feeling?
Of course, I've done it. I've tried forcing encounters.
Yeah, so I'm there, and what was the name of that place, Spot?
I have no idea.
Come
what you're
on, dude.
About.
There was like an apple outside the club. Seaside Heights, back in the day. It's like a hot spot. Damn, you suck.
Yeah,
so anyway, apple. I'm there. I'm at this place, right? And I bring another girl with me. An old coworker who was really hot, though.
For what reason?
Just to fucking inspire the jealousy and make her question, like, who's he with?
Oh, my God.
What's going on? Oh, to be the mystery man that she left behind, right?
Seems like this has all the makings of something that's going to backfire.
Oh, dude. On a throwback Thursday, I bring this up just to let everyone know how pathetic I am. No.
End scene.
We've all been there. We've all done that. We've all made these desperate attempts and mistakes to force encounters, and we've all had these, maybe even random ones. I'd love to hear the random ones, you know, that may have happened, and you're like, oh my God. But this one I forced. And I remember going there, and she like, what are you doing here? She's dancing. I'm like, I'm just here to see you. And she's like, you know, I remember her being, she's like,
I'm done with you, though.
I remember her, she's like looking up, all high. She's like, I'm just really happy now. Like, I moved on. And I remember she wasn't even like making eye contact. Aww. I was like, her expressions are different.
She's changed.
What do you do? Who are you now?
I'm not like, the same girl you used to know. Beat it.
So I walk away all sad, and I'm talking to the girl I'm with. And she's like, oh, don't worry, you know. And I'm trying to make a night of it, right?
Yeah.
But then I get courage. I go to the bathroom, and I look at myself in the mirror. I'm like, come on, bro. She still wants it. So I come back out again. Maybe a few times this happened. Long story short.
Too late.
Thank you. I go out there again, and she like gestures to the security guys, because now she has a new scene, so she probably knows everybody there, right?
And dude, it's him over there, that guy.
Yeah, so
the guy with the onyx earrings.
So here I am, right? You know, thinking like I'm the man, and I'm gonna win her back somehow with my plea and her and jealousy. These guys fucking took me like,
dude, by the collar.
They took me literally, like you see in a movie, by the back of my pants
and heave hoja
and by the shirt and. Whew, threw me out, dude. Through the doors.
Oh, that's great.
Came busting through the doors on the floor, Seaside Heights, and I'm there with this girl who's smoking hot, who thinks I'm a total loser right now because I got kicked out of the club. So I ended up getting kicked out of the club as I look back.
Looks like it sounded like a good idea from the beginning. How that failed, I don't know.
To win her back with the forced encounter. Now, because of that picture, I was inspired to, you know, talk about this and those random encounters.
Balboa.
Spot. Anything come to mind for you, like weird encounters? Like, you ever run into a random puppy and wonder where the fuck? Oh my God, what are the chances?
Spot's got a random puppy.
Like right now, like where did I get a random puppy?
Are you kidding me, dude, with that thing?
Look at that.
You kidding me? Hold on. For those of you who listen to our radio show, know that Rich found a puppy.
Oh, I didn't find the puppy.
Oh, Rich's ex-girlfriend. Speaking of ex-girlfriends, Rich's ex-girlfriend, who he's pals with.
That's not awkward.
Yeah, until she has you thrown out
of
the club.
Well, you know what's more awkward? Me hanging out with my ex and being pals, or you getting heave-hoed out of a club? It seems like I fucking win. You mock me all the time. You say I talk to all my exes. I'm friendly with some of them.
Ago.
So the options are
years ago.
The options are be friendly with them.
Years ago.
Or I don't know, kicked out of an establishment.
I'm a grown-ass man and a grown-ass man, and I would never do that now.
I think
you should
be embarrassed.
Dude, we're talking early.
You
like
should
I'm
look
22,
to me
21
for advice.
Years old.
So, yeah, Jen finds this dog in a dumpster. Someone threw this out in a box in a dumpster. And
speaking of random encounters,
she, from what I understand, was walking out of like a health food store, like a juice place.
Yeah.
And heard like a whimper coming from the garbage, and just had the instinct to be like, something's in there. Asked some guy, can you open it up? And this dog that Spot's holding is in a box. Someone threw this dog out.
I want to like find this person now and like destroy them. Look at this thing.
This thing is five. They said it's 5 or 6
this
weeks
thing
old.
Is
I they think
took
it's
we
cute.
We ate this thing.
We made it homemade form. We made it formula.
What kind of dog is that?
They say it's a terrier mix.
Took it to the vet, and the
but
vet
it's
says
the cute, it has, it's the cutest thing I've ever seen.
The vet saying it's gonna be like 20 pounds, maybe most, and it's a little terrier mix, and it seems to be perfectly healthy. So we are attempting to find a home for this little pup. And I think our buddy Curtis in California.
Yeah.
And Connie might.
How do you know he didn't want to surprise her?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think they might come by tomorrow. I think that might be the plan. They want to take a look at the dog.
Well, you better hope he's not watching with her right now, because you may have just blown it.
Well, I'm pretty sure they're in the loop.
Oh my god, it's adorable.
Is that the cool spot? Put him up here.
Maybe it was my destiny to have this dog.
No.
Hold on. You sure?
Not now. You're allergic to everything.
Yeah, if I get another dog.
I think we'll get more views if we let it play with my beard.
I want it to be a hypoallergenic dog. Put it up here. But do you have any rando encounters aside from, you know, the one of...
With my ex, where she brought a dog to our house?
And the one when, yeah.
And my wife and I, combined with my ex and are finding a dog at home.
Any come to mind, though, or no?
I had one terrible encounter with an ex. Now, this is a girl that I dated for years of my life. Yeah. Years of my life. And she was the one girl I ever dated. You make fun of me for hanging and talking to all my exes. This is the one girl that...
Yeah, I mean, you know, you have an established life.
This is the one... Yeah, put her here. Put him over here. This is the one girl in my life...
She's scared. He's shaking.
Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness.
She's scared of.
This is the one girl in my life that... I didn't realize how sensitive I was. This is the one girl in my life that, after we broke up, when she's like, we're done, it's over, I'm never going to see you again, she stuck to it. Like, stuck to it where... No calls, emails, anything.
And it blew your mind.
And it blew my mind. I'm like, she didn't even... I'm going to kill myself. No, you know the rebound... You know when you have...
No, I know,
even if
sick in your family...
Oh, you're looking going through a rough time.
You're looking for sympathy.
You're trying to do anything you can, right?
My grandma's really sick.
That's bad. Nothing I did.
You're doing anything just to get their attention.
Of course.
And you didn't have social media, so you had to be outlandish.
Nothing I did could get this girl's attention. I'm saying, you know, even if you don't ever hook up again, she'll at least meet you for coffee or a drink to be like, yeah, what do you want?
Right.
What do you need? You need closure? Fine. We'll meet for coffee. She didn't even say goodbye. Fast forward like 4 or 5 years. What a coincidence. She works in the same building as I do.
What?
Yeah, where I worked at Z100, the radio station in New York, Lehman Brothers and a couple other banking companies were in that building. The elevator opens and I hear her voice. I hear her laugh.
Right.
My stomach drops. She gets on the elevator, looks at me, stops talking, and I froze. I'm like, She got off the next floor and I was like, And never said a word.
Well, if she could see you now with that puppy.
I know. You want to say one of them?
No.
No.
Well, here's the deal on the, you know, not to breeze past your story because I want to hear how
it ended. I did? Puppy. I went to the directory of her build, of the company, and I was like, let me get her extension. And I called her and I'm like, I just saw you in the elevator. How weird. We should catch up. And she's like, leave me alone.
Wait, that was a creepy move. That was a little creepy, no, Spot?
A little creepy.
You scoped
the building we lived. We
you
worked
never got
in.
Over.
Yeah,
had,
it's kind of creepy.
The building we worked in had a directory in the front where you could touch screen anyone's name that
and
worked
she
in the building.
You again?
She was like, "No, goodbye." Click.
Oh, cold blooded.
Adios mio.
Oh man, God. Still not as bad as getting thrown out of the club head first, but still, that was a good one. I like that.
I know.
I like that.
So you think our boy Curtis or so, yeah, I'm sure someone will take this dog, right? So, yeah. We just want to make sure this dog gets a good home. It's so cute, man.
It's so cute, man.
It's like a pound.
Look at that little thing.
How tiny is he?
So tiny.
Isn't it such a shame to think that someone threw this dog in a dumpster? Like, what type of scumbag on earth would be like, here, come on.
It's like that kid we know.
Just
who's
touch
a,
him. Come on, just touch him.
I don't want to touch him. I just don't want to get all sick. That's all.
Just love him.
Hello. If I get another dog, I want to get a hypoallergenic dog. So, you know, that's nothing against this dog.
I want him back.
What's his name? Yes.
I call him Dobby because he has floppy ears like in Harry Potter.
Here goes,
like Spotty. Like a typical dumpster dog. He's trying to have a drink of my booze.
Take your little pup back there, Spotty.
Really cute, man. That's the dog. That's the one. Someone threw that away. That's unbelievable.
Is that crazy?
That's unbelievable.
What a scumbag.
Random encounters.
We digress. Let's back to the action. But, yeah,
I just thought it was so random that Stallone ran into Dolph Lundgren just at lunch. I never see anybody cool, you know?
Let alone these two guys being like, oh, how coincidental that we...
Right.
Come on, Rocky IV.
Yeah, that's very strange.
That you don't belong to.
All right, so more feedback at 412, the letters C in our show. 412, the letters C in our show. People are saying, where's Al B?
I miss Al B.
Al B's not here right now.
We turned him into a dog.
Albie is a puppy.
He's our pal who lives with me at the moment. I used to work with him back in the day for years, who hangs out with us on Thursday Night Live. He said if you want to get drinks later, he'll hang out.
I'm in.
Let's see. What a treat it is to hear and see you guys on Thursdays. Love the show forever. Man. That's from Marla in Texas. What's up, Marla? Thanks for all the support.
And by the way, pass the link around if you want anyone to check out our show that doesn't have Sirius XM. This is a good opportunity for them to see what we're all about, a little bit at least, right? And they can see the dog burrowing in Spot's beard.
He's like,
how could you not want that dog if you're having this bond and connection with it?
I love this thing so much.
I told Spot, until your wife gets here,
yeah,
you could have the dog at our house. And he's saying no.
He's biting my hoodie. Now he's biting my beard.
You don't want the dog, huh?
Spot wants that dog so bad.
You're in the market for a dog.
You know, Spot is secretly mad at his wife because if she was already living here, he said he would have taken it.
Well, why can't you take it?
I think Curtis and Callie may have found themselves a dope dog.
I don't have my own place.
Oh, look at you. Guys, could have been.
You think it'll never remember what? It was thrown in a box, right?
No.
No, it's just going to love even more.
Remember it was thrown in a beard?
Yeah, I don't know. It might never remember any of that.
Right, well, let's go from sensitive doggies.
By the way, think of all the chicks I could land with this.
Yeah. Let's go from sensitive doggies, read some feedback, and then I want to play a video to show that not only are we sensitive, we do love a good online fight. Because I saw a video today online that is so... I mean, this is rough, man. This is rough. Now, in the beginning...
I saw the same one. Did Hustle City G post this on our Facebook page?
There's a guy that posts all these hilarious World Star videos. You know, get the feedback compiled while we play this video. It's a little long. I mean, it's a minute. You could play the beginning and see that these two guys are tussling at what looks like a 7-Eleven, a convenience store, maybe a Wawa, a Quick Check. What else? Give me another.
What's the one in Philly?
A Circle K?
No.
Oh, Sheetz.
Sheetz.
Yeah. Look at it. So these guys are going at it.
Loves.
Quick Check.
I said that one. But look, they're knocking over displays. They're acting like assholes. And the owner locked the door. The owner said, "Get out." And then after a while, you could see that the owner went to go.
Now you can't leave.
Locked the door. So the guy in the black hoodie essentially beats the shit out of the guy in the white, right?
Yeah.
There's a guy taping. He's like, "World Star, I'm laughing."
I mean, clearly this guy is, I mean, he looks like quite the lowlife, right?
And then the guy in the white shirt's like, "Yo, you messed up, man. You messed up." Now the guy in the black hoodie, I don't know if you could hear it, he's saying, "Let me out of the store. Let me out. Don't call the cops." This guy goes over.
Grabs a 40.
And you don't see, the guy in the black hoodie doesn't see it coming. This is a 40. Listen to the thud.
A full 40.
Uh-oh. Here we go. Oh.
Here it comes.
Oh!
Wait, again, watch. Oh my God!
Vicious!
Then he goes to grab another one, but watch what happens.
He's like, "Yo, I'm gonna cut you, sucker!
Yo, listen, you ain't so bad now! Holes!"
Yeah. So, that is the viral, ruthless fight of the week, huh?
Check this out. He grabs another one, but watch what happens. This guy gets up, and he's like, "No, man," and then he falls over. Look at that.
Oh, no.
That
poor
is
guy.
Vicious.
Two boneheads. Actually, three boneheads. The guy videotaping it, too.
This makes me think of a move that happened in college one time. I saw a guy pull this off, and I always kept it in the back of my pocket, in the back of my mind.
Oh, and the guy broke the bottle, and then when someone goes, "What are you doing?" He goes, "I'm just looking for the other half of this bottle."
No, man.
Happy Gilmore style?
Some guy. Even cooler, though. Like, there was, like, a fight broke out. It was, like, a little tussle at one of the bars in my college, right?
When he popped out, he popped the bottom.
He goes, he went, and the bottom popped out.
And he had, like, a...
And he's like, "Yo, let's go!"
Listen, vato loco!
You don't mess with a guy that does that. No tricks
any
like
guy,
that.
Any guy, when a fight looks like it's about to start, when he goes... And holds a glass weapon.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That guy
don't
was
mess
ready
with
to
that
roll.
Guy.
All I had was a switch comb. I was like, "Yo, I'm not ready
I'm not
for all
down.
This."
I'm not down
with that. But a viral clip that we definitely wanted to share with you guys today.
And you know, as far as little videos or clips or memes, I don't know if Steve got the one of he does of Steve Kerr, coach of the NBA, possible record breaking Washington Golden State Warriors.
This is
now,
cool.
What I find interesting is, think about it.
He's involved in all three levels.
He's involved in every aspect of this. His team...
Spot, you're not a sports guy. You should find this interesting still.
His teammates, Steve Kerr played with Duncan and Ginobili and those guys at the very end of his career. So he played with the Spurs. The team
with,
that is...
With guys that still play on the Spurs.
And later on tonight, in fact, I think the game is on now, who is looking to prevent the team he coaches now, the Warriors, from beating the record of the team he broke the record with, the Bulls.
You know that's so, cool?
Spot's petting the dog and doesn't give a fuck.
You don't care.
I don't really care.
You don't care at all.
Oh, the dog's chewing your finger.
Yeah.
Cute.
No, dude, I feel like you and that dog are meant to be, bro. People are saying that puppy looks like Yoda. Cello Fellow says.
You think so?
It looks like Yoda. It does look like Yoda. He's called Yoda. Yeah, look at his ears.
So whether it's Curtis and Callie or Spot or whoever, I'm sure that dog will find a good home, right?
I'm just glad. You know what the thing is? I'll tell you what. Layla would have wanted that dog, and she's not in town.
Yeah?
And that dog, you know, as cute as it is, man, I'm just thinking of all the hair all over my house and me suffering as a result.
It's so soft, too.
Yeah, it's a cute dog, though.
But you know what? I will say, that dog?
Yeah.
That dog, like, I still can't believe how someone would get rid of it. And then I'm thinking also...
Can this be our new show mascot?
maybe we... No, we can't. The thing about dog rescue, here's the thing. There's so many people that do great dog rescue, and they also do things, like I said, more importantly, for humans.
Yeah.
But anyone that does any good deed, whether it's working at a shelter or an old people's home or a dog rescue, anything for humans or dogs or pets, any type of compassionate work, I'm not cut out for it. Not because I don't want to do the good deeds. It's just there's so much sadness that goes along with it. I know. See, I'm bringing down the mood again. But
sorry.
You don't agree? Think about it. If you like volunteer with old people.
By the way, I think there's something in the air today. I really do.
Because the whole show's been like a sad day.
Our radio show, if you guys heard it was the most gloomy show.
It rained in LA today.
And I was thinking,
it was the only day it's rained in months.
I swear. I was like, there has to be something to it. And when I got home, my sister was like, I don't know. There's just something going on today. It's just been such a terrible day. I'm like, you too? Us too.
It's a rainy,
she's
weird.
Like, her son was cranky. My daughter was cranky. Dude, everyone was bitchy. Everything was glum and gloomy.
It is raining. It's raining in Southern California, which never happens.
I'm telling you, it's a weird vibe.
Well, I'll say, when you say doing all the things I was saying, old people home. What do you deal with? These people you get close to, then they die.
You live and then you die.
You help out and you do great things with sick kids. What happens? Some of them don't make it. Right. You work with dogs, you can't adopt all of them out, so some of them have to be put down. It's like almost as if the nicest shit that you could do results in you really having heartache or something.
Just saying.
Sorry.
So, yeah, man. Yeah.
So, Spot, hit up Curtis and Callie, because if he doesn't, if him and Connie, who are great, don't want to adopt this little pup and take him, I feel like he's yours.
Yeah. I know. You guys look so cute together, bro.
Thanks.
Let's see. Pueblo, Colorado says, finally got my wife watching the show. What's up, Shane in Maryland?
Hey, wife.
You need to check out our radio show, too. Radio show every day mornings on Rush 93, Sirius XM. Tomorrow, again, Melissa McCarthy's husband, Ben Falcone.
Who also stars in The Boss.
The Boss
with
that comes out this
weekend.
He directed,
wrote, produced.
Yeah, he made the movie.
Yeah. It's his baby, essentially.
Yeah. Can you work closely with your wife like that?
Maybe. I don't know.
I feel like you guys are both passionate, but I feel like creatively and just working together, you'd probably butt heads. You're probably better supporting each other than working together.
Speaking of butt heads.
Really? That's the maturity level. All-time high.
Let's see.
Any other feedback
Jimmy
or notes?
Jimmy Jam says, first time watching, bro. Like it. I like it. Go, like baby, it. Go.
Thank you. Jimmy Jam.
Is Spot up for adoption, too? That's from Ohio.
Oh.
Everybody likes the beard, dude. Beard guy.
Sure, for the next couple months.
That puppy has grown close to you. That's dangerous, Spot.
People love my off-color jokes today. I like
good,
that.
Good,
well,
good.
Do you think it's because I breastfed him the first night he came over?
Probably.
Suckle on your nipple?
On my teats?
Spot, did you ever make
another off-color peanut butter joke, but I guess I won't, right? Too obvious?
No, there's a... There's another picture that's floating around the internet. I didn't send it.
Aura says you need to keep it, Spotty. All right, Garrett, which
I was.
One?
We talked about this for a minute today on the show, but remember we were saying how Hillary Clinton's riding the subway in New York City.
Yeah.
And does that make her seem?
I mean, it's just forced.
Does
it's
it
so
humanize
forced.
Her? Does it make her more human?
A lot of feedback came in though. They're like, she's the most out of touch woman on the planet. She hasn't even drove a car in over 20 years.
Well, the president and the family doesn't drive. Yeah.
I mean, she's doing what she can to say, hey, I relate.
So they were deciding, this is the big
I understand.
I am just like you. I'm Hillary Clinton.
I am one of
you. I relate to what you go through.
I drove the subway.
You rode the subway.
I rode the subway.
With the common people. I'm one of you.
So the
vote for me.
The discrepancy was... Yeah. Did she seem more like a New Yorker because she had to swipe her Metro card like two or three times to get it to work? Or did she look like a doofus that couldn't work her Metro card?
Was it? Didn't
Because the feedback on social media was so split. Half the people are like Hillary's a real New Yorker. Her shitty Metro card didn't work. And then the other people were saying how terrible that she's trying to be like everyone, but can't figure out how to work a Metro card.
Damned if you don't. And in everything you do as a public figure, in today's world, you're so scrutinized under the microscope, especially being a public figure and getting feedback online.
Oh my God.
People are just waiting to pounce every second of every moment. So regardless, she was going to get shit on. You know that.
Yeah,
so,
no matter what she did.
Yeah, you have to expect that.
And there's another video going around. Steve, sorry I didn't send it to you earlier, but at midnight, the Chris Hardwick show.
Yeah.
Spot, would you say the best impressions of Bernie Sanders and Donald Trump to date? These two comedians, I don't even know the names to give them props, but Spot, if you want to look it up, but these two guys, I've never seen... I mean, there's guys that do Trump well.
No, it has. It's gone viral as other, like, the best impressions.
I think
Jimmy Fallon does a good Trump.
But other than Larry David, though, who just seems so much like Bernie Sanders. Besides Larry David, the guy that does Bernie Sanders here, to me, is unbelievable. So if you want to play a little bit of this, these impressions are unbelievable. By the way, Chris Hardwick dominating, huh?
Good for him.
Land of ours and also Michigan have been tasked with the incredible.
I'm gonna get my headphones listening to what you guys a little bit.
President, and boy have they been blowing it. But a field that started with 21 presidential candidates.
Can you believe it did start with 21 people? This is the longest drawn out election coverage of all time.
Big Brother's jacket, adorable.
You want to fast forward a little bit, Steve, to the impressions? Okay, you can just zip through it.
To our stage for a very special extended hour-long presidential debate here on
The guys that do Trump and Bernie Sanders. Unbelievable.
Thing is, I've seen this online all day, but I haven't yet clicked on it. No.
Get out of here.
You came here and we appreciate it.
It's like Doc Emmett Brown.
I don't think this guy's going to make it to the election. I mean, you're kidding me? Unbelievable.
The other viral thing regarding Trump today is they're saying Owen Wilson looks like him a little bit.
What?
A young Donald Trump. They were doing side-by-sides. That's it? Did we see the rest of it?
No, that's...
Trump versus Bernie.
Oh, shit, that was just a preview. Honestly, guys, check it out online if you can.
Oh, teased me.
Oh, it's a good tease.
Yeah, good tease.
What a tease.
Oh, my God. That's terrible. All right, Playa del Rey, California hits us up. We're live, by the way, Thursday Night Live, Covino and Rich, 412 to letter CNR show, 412-CNR show. Spot should definitely keep the puppy. That's from Maria.
Maria. But here's the deal.
Hillary Clinton. I'm a robot. That's from Saskatoon.
I know what I find interesting, though. If Spot does keep this puppy...
I love how Spot is just, like, totally zoned us out. Look at the puppy sleeping.
Puppy's sleeping on your chest.
Yeah, bro.
My big man chest.
No,
my
dude.
Man chest.
I don't know. You guys are, like, one.
But here's the deal.
You're like Elliot to his E.T.
The update is that your wife's not here for months still.
I know.
So what are you going to do? You're going to live with this... it's now you and your new puppy in my place?
Yeah, that's the thing. It's his call. It's his house.
You can't be an Indian giver. You already said he could.
I know, but I'm saying, I just wonder, does he want the responsibility of a puppy, and then his wife moves here and he moves? Like, it's a lot.
It's a big responsibility.
I think he could handle the puppy, dude. You don't think so? Again, whatever.
Now I'm gonna be tied to this little fella for the next
15 years.
Yeah.
Whatever's meant to be. Curtis
and Callie's on standby, and I'll tell you why I like the idea of Curtis and Callie and Connie taking the dog.
Yeah,
because then we could sort of see how it grows up
and see. Yeah, yeah.
Meaning, like, we see our buddy Curtis, who we met through the show, enough where
you'll get updates.
Occasionally, you'll see a Facebook photo, or he'll be like, "Yeah, here's how the dog is doing."
He'll send you pictures every once in a while.
He's the adopted. They're the adopted parents. We're the biological parents.
And we secretly
get updates.
Oh my God! See, the scary part for me is not knowing what that dog's gonna grow up to be and look like. And you shouldn't care. That's just a superficial thought that I'm having.
What do you think it's gonna grow? I don't think it'll get big. So is that the only thing, really?
But what's his shape like? What's it gonna be? Because it's kind of long.
It's gonna be on all fours.
You thought it was a beagle. It's not a beagle. But it's kind of shaped like a
Wiener dog.
Like a wiener dog a little bit.
Yeah, it's like short and stubby.
I never saw myself as a wiener dog. Guy. A wiener dog guy.
You're just a wiener guy.
Yeah, I'm just a wiener guy.
By the way, did no one ever connect the dots that Layla met you and she had two chihuahuas and she just loves all Mexican things?
Yeah.
Did no one ever connect the dots on that?
Yeah.
Well, one chihuahua. Now.
That's why people are saying I should take this dog, but oh man, I gotta be honest. I'm feeling some type of way seeing the spot. Hold it.
I feel like
you should keep it, and then there's a part of me that's saying,
Curtis
maybe,
and Connie.
Maybe I was meant to keep that dog.
Like, this dog came into all of our lives.
Yeah.
And by the way,
I lost my dog 2 weeks ago.
Just from talking about it on the show, on the radio show,
yeah.
So much feedback of people saying, I'm in California, yo, you know, hit me up if you really can't find someone. So it's good to know there's good people out there. On a positive note.
People fully appreciate this dog.
If Spot takes the dog, he will never come out. That's from JT in Saskatchewan. Spot can handle a puppy. He's handled you two dummies, you two dogs for years. That's from Jamie in Boston.
I know it's a little blurry, but look at him.
Jimmy Jam said, Spot could use a companion because his right hand ain't cutting it. I think that's what he's saying. I'm trying to read this. Thank you, Jimmy Jam. Keep the dog, Spot. You two are made for each other. That's from Brian in Kokomo. Brian the Warlock in Kokomo.
Oh.
Look at that, dude. That's really heartless, huh? But then again, like we said on the show, not to be negative Norberto again.
It was probably a homeless person.
People do that with babies, bro.
People do with babies.
Living babies, you know?
Yeah, how are people oh my God, people are bad.
The story that always comes to mind, not to be negative Norberto again.
Like girls that go to their prom and birth a baby into the toilet at their prom.
What?
You've heard those stories, right? Growing up?
What stories are you talking about?
You never heard that story. It was like in Jersey when we were growing up that some girl birthed a baby at a prom and left it in the toilet.
Rich's cousin.
Harriet. No. You never heard that story.
Maybe.
You never heard the story.
The one that comes to mind to me is the baby that survived in the pipes. And they found it in the pipes. That is like, imagine that.
That guy grows up, he's like, I'm Pipe Man. Like,
what's the name of that character that Nick Kroll plays when he was a toilet baby? He was born in the toilet.
Caesar,
I'm a toilet baby. Caesar, he's the dog version of that. He's a dumpster dog. So sad.
It's like, no, he's like the junkyard dog.
It really is so sad, man.
He's shivering. He's cold spot. Put him in your jacket.
That is
put him in your beard.
Put him
in your jacket and let his head
pop
out.
Not to sound corny or anything, you know, but that's like a miracle dog. The fact that he made it through.
Yeah.
Like, what was the guy thinking? Like, well, if he's meant to survive, I guess he will.
I don't know.
And he threw him in the dumpster?
I will say this. You got to say great work by Jen.
Look at him.
Oh, yeah.
Great work by Jen to find the dog in the dumpster. I mean,
again, Rich's ex-girlfriend.
Think about it. Jen's walking past a dumpster.
For sure.
You hear a little squeal. You may just not stop because you're like, I don't need
it could be anything. It's a dumpster. It could be a raccoon, or it could be a rat.
Yeah, so the fact that Jen found this dog and, you know, we're happy to help her. So it's really her that did the finding, but now we're trying to help it find a home. So
sorry. So, hey, guys, basically this is like a little telethon right here.
For Dobby. Yeah, we came here unprepared tonight because we're tired this week.
For yourself. I'm having fun, man.
I'm having fun, too.
If you want to, you know, find this dog a home, by all means, hit us up, 412 letter CNR show. The league leader right now is our pal from the show.
Curtis and Cali is the league leader. He reached out very sincerely.
Reach my drink.
But Spot, I mean, if you want the dog, I'd imagine you get first crack, but you may need to talk to
Curtis. All right, so where do we go next? There's two stories I wanted to get to.
I mean, we're almost done.
We are?
Dude.
So I could save these for the radio show for tomorrow.
Please do. What's coming up on tomorrow's radio show?
Ben Falcone, again, the boss, will be here. And then we might discuss this story about Sweeney Todd. Now, Spot, pull up the details here. I know this is Popcorn Talk. Pull them up, seriously.
This is Popcorn Talk. The Demon Barber of Fleet Street?
Can you pull it up on the big computer that's in front of you?
Come on, bro. What are you doing besides playing with the dog?
I got a dog in my hand. It's very hard to do things when I got a dog in my hand.
You could help, okay? You can help.
So could you, Bozos. Computer boy.
You can help. I'm doing feedback. I'm doing the story. I'm doing the hosting.
You're doing a lot. Could you take the computer from him
and actually use it? Come on.
All right. Well, the gist is
that. What's Rich doing?
I'm doing
more than anybody.
Just being me, bro.
It's being you.
It's bringing the heat, bro.
Yeah, bringing the heat. Where?
making Let's notes. See.
Oh man, was it Mark in Colorado that threw the dog in the dumpster? Apparently, that sounded a lot.
Oh no, you did your mark. Like, this dog will survive.
This is sweet. I get to hang out with you guys in the morning, and now at night in my garage. It's from Salt Lake City, Utah. What's up,
Thank you, Salt Lake City?
Thank you guys. It'll be a good puppy, personally, if it's on Piper Waffles.
Yeah,
Brad in Ontario, your dog will be a good influence on this dog, he's saying. Spot, you got to keep the dog. A lot of people are just sitting us up saying you got to keep the dog.
I think Curtis and Kelly and Spot. That's the
maybe the mascot for the show.
We could have like a shared dog.
A shared dog?
We could have visitation rights.
Well, anyway, you know, we'll dive. I'll give you the gist of the story, okay? Since, you know, none of you failed to play along with me.
I don't even know what story you're talking about.
You know the Demon Barber of Fleet Street. You know the movie.
Sweeney Todd. Sweeney Todd. I mean, I only
you might know the play.
I never saw it, but I know that it's a barber that like slits its patients' its customers' throats, and then they go down like a chute.
Yeah, but then they don't they sell the people in pies,
and then they turn them into pies.
Yeah, people are like, oh, these pies are delicious.
So let me guess, someone in this high school production accidentally cut someone's neck.
Yes.
What?
Yes.
What?
Yeah.
What?
And cut their head off.
And then made them into a pie.
Just
kidding.
No. That's really method acting.
No, but they had cut the production and you know take the people.
Like,
I think it was two people to be honest, because they try to keep it as real as possible.
Next,
I swear to God, yeah, it's a real story, and it wasn't in the Mexican Sun, the Soul, or what was the other one you said the other day?
Soul.
Batboy Magazine.
Batboy Magazine.
It was none of those. It was a real story that I read from actually WPIX. So I'm guessing maybe it was a New York story. Oh, it's actually in New Zealand, a New Zealand high school.
Oh, New Zealand.
But reported in our PIX. New York on
New
our
Zealand,
local
New York.
Our news. Yeah. See?
Same thing.
Throat-slitting scene in a high school production of Sweeney Todd goes horribly wrong. So we'll talk about that tomorrow in further detail.
Great. The crowd must have thought it was great effects.
And because you've been really hard on my Mexican words of the day, I'll do this one now just to be a little...
Mexican word of the day!
Of the weekend.
We can end the show with a Mexican word of the day?
We're going to talk about the movies that are coming out still. Yeah, we got time. We're chilling, man. Big rush to go where? Go home and play with the puppy?
Well,
you're chilling. Thursday
I'm just,
night.
I'm just tired.
Live, hanging out.
I'm done with you. I've seen you enough today.
You gotta leave him wanting more, bro.
Mexican word of the day?
Yes,
no?
I do.
Mexican word of the day is herpes.
Oh.
Herpes.
Rich, something you're very familiar with.
Herpes.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Shit. I forgot. I forget we're live. I'm just.
Can I tell you something? We have a friend.
Like you're chilling.
We have a friend that almost hooked up with a girl with a terrible case of herpes.
I tell my brother that.
And
we
warned him last minute, and he was so thankful.
Yeah. Oh, I tell my brother, like, dude, whatever you
not
do.
Not that there's anything wrong with the girl. It's just she was.
I mean, if she has herpes, I mean, it's not
the
best thing.
But he was unaware. And you need like.
I mean, look. A lot of people have herpes.
A lot of people.
Nobody wants it, right?
No one wants it.
I'm not trying to be.
No one wants. Are you
trying to be politically correct about herpes?
No, I'm saying this guy was about to hook up with a girl.
Yeah.
And I think she didn't have like cold sore herpes. I think she had like what's going on downstairs.
Yeah.
Herpes.
Big difference.
Yes.
Yeah.
So,
it doesn't make you a bad person.
But he was going. He was going to go back to the.
You get that for life.
He was going to go back to a hotel with her. And we all gave this friend a little like, hey, buddy boy, might not want to do that. And he was like, whoa, you just caught me. I was about to leave. Like, if we didn't catch him, who knows?
Herpes. Any herpes story, Spot?
I'm good.
No. All right, go ahead. Word of the day. Herpes.
Herpes. Ah, we cut the burrito in half. That way I can have my piece and she can have her piece. See, that's why I said I'll do it now.
No, that's why we need the theme song. Yeah.
Herpes.
You don't like
herpes.
That one?
No?
All right, so.
All right, movies this weekend.
Because it's popcorn talk, what comes out this weekend, Spot?
A few solid movies that I think are worth checking out.
Okay.
But, so you decide.
I'm down for a movie. I want to see The Boss, only because I respect Melissa McCarthy, and Ben Falcone's a good dude.
She lost a lot of weight, huh?
And and listen, man, she's cool. She's a cool chick. So
I get that she's a box office draw. And she's one of the biggest stars out there, and I give her all the credit in the world. Right? She's personable, lovely lady. I don't think she's that funny, man. And I'm not saying that
you're sexist. You don't think women are funny?
Yeah, but it very well might be a little bit of that.
You don't think any women are funny? You don't think Amy Schumer's funny? You don't think Melissa McCarthy's funny?
No,
you don't
think
any
women you think are funny are funny?
Well, I'm just naming like the biggest women in the game right now.
You know what? That's not nice. Her humor is kind of adapted. Her earlier roles, like in like Bridesmaids or they used to be a little bit more crass. Now it's kind of like a, I don't know, it's evolved humor.
Spy, I thought like,
Spy was hilarious. I
think Spy was great. Chick comedies, that's how I feel.
No,
like,
Spy was
I feel
not
like
a chick
not
comedy.
Geared for
no.
me. You know
Spy,
what I mean?
Spy was not.
I'm
not
saying
funny.
I won't enjoy it.
Spy,
I'm saying I'm not. There's no interest there for me.
Do you see Spy?
There's no interest again. Yeah, none.
It's not a chick movie. Yeah. Spy was great.
Maybe it was. I'm not denying it. But so, the ones I've seen, I'm not.
So the boss out this weekend.
Yeah.
I think probably going to be the number one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that's the biggest draw. Yeah,
no, dude. Just because I don't think it doesn't mean she's not awesome.
It's like it's kind of like a Martha Stewart-esque story where she goes to jail and then. Just to come out and kind of, you know, make her name for herself again.
Leona Helmsley was the character, wasn't it?
Like an inspiration, yeah.
Was that, okay. Hardcore Henry is getting a lot of buzz.
That's the first person.
That's the first person movie, which, if you have motion sickness like me, will make you sick up to within 5 minutes
looks
of
the movie. Looks terrible
to me. It looks interesting, though. It's an interesting concept, which, you know how you've seen the like that viral video floating around where like it's the guy who's like, Going around, flying around.
Cool concept, but I can't imagine watching a movie that looks like it's shot on essentially a GoPro.
That's what they said about Blair Witch Project, and it made millions.
No, this may make a lot of money, but I'm
that's
just
what
saying.
They said about Paranormal Activity.
I have zero interest.
How many times have you seen? See, you say zero interest there. I'm more interested in this. It's just like things are geared toward different people. You know what I mean?
You want to see GoPro?
As similar as we are, we're just different people. Okay. I'm way more interested in seeing that. But Blair Witch, here's the interesting part. Although interested to see it when it came out and everything and enjoyed it, I never watched that again, ever.
Oh, no, me neither.
Yeah, I think Blair Witch might lead the league in movies that you never watched. I don't think anyone said, you want to watch Blair Witch again?
Never. Yeah, never happened.
There may not be a movie that...
What's Hardcore Hank about, though?
I think it's just an action kind of movie. I'm going to look at...
Okay. All right, so that's out this weekend.
Yeah.
All right, so far the boss is the league leader.
Yeah, and then Demolition with Jake Gyllenhaal.
Okay.
It's that you may have seen the previews. It's where he loses his wife in a car crash.
Yeah.
And he's like losing his mind and you know trying to find his way.
Like a drama type.
Yeah, it's like he's an...
Like a dark drama?
It's like he was an investment banker, I think. Is that right? Yeah, he was an investment banker, loses his wife. Dark, like you might say, a dark comedy.
Okay, comedy or dark drama?
Dark drama, dramedy.
Drama. Okay.
I think it probably has some comedic elements.
You know what that? Know what that reeks of?
But more drama.
That
than comedy.
That reeks of a movie I will absolutely get at Redbox or on demand. I just that doesn't seem to be a box office movie for me.
All right, Spot. Hold on. Hold your thoughts. I got more feedback coming in. Thursday Night Live, we are Covino and Rich from Sirius XM. You can text us at 412, the letter C in our show. Getting ready for the weekend, having some cocktails, talking about the movies coming out. Name the puppy Gizmo. I don't know if people can even see the puppy if they just joined us, but that's a puppy. It's not Spot's hairy chest. Oh, shit, she got the herpsters. Gross. That's from Saskatoon. Jimmy Jam saying Three's Company. Spot. Curtis and Wiener Dog. Maybe it's a shared thing. Let's see. Spot, this is from Brentwood, New York. Spot, keep the puppy and please keep Thursday Night Live going. He's loving it. Having a good night, having drinks with us at home. So we appreciate
that.
We're in it. Yeah. Thank you guys for hanging out with us, Brentwood, New York. Great show, guys. Tex is digging it. The laid back vibe. Because on the show, on the morning show, on the radio, we're there to get people fired up. Here we're hanging out, getting ready for the weekend.
That's so funny how you go into things with like a particular mood. Like I feel no. Do you feel any different now than the radio show?
Yeah, completely.
Like you're like laid back mood. Honestly, I'm telling you right now, I feel no different now than in the morning.
It's because you're Mr. Hyperpants all the time.
No, but I'm saying because you put your leg up. That's different.
Yeah.
How are you different now?
Legs up. You know what that means.
Chilling. But how is
man, it? Your man
I'm missing.
Yeah, but why
thing I'm missing is my huge basketball shorts.
But you don't think it's a little silly how he goes, oh, it's a different vibe? What is the different vibe?
Vibe.
I think I'm totally... I don't drink on the morning radio show, hanging out, just winging it, having fun. It's completely
different.
It's
pretty
different.
Similar.
Not really.
What do you do in the morning?
Do you drink?
The only variable is a glass of bourbon or scotch?
It's completely different. Yes, completely different. I mean, is it, really, is it really the fight? The fight?
You want to fight? Fight? You guys want to fight?
No, because you know why? Because on the morning show, we fight.
Do it.
And this is more of a laid-back vibe.
Yeah, but is it. I mean, yeah, you're right, because I don't even have the energy to engage that.
But then, you know what? You're right. So different.
Yeah, I don't even. So it's not even, hey, bro, you're trying to kill my bife.
You're going
to
let him get by with that?
No.
Yeah, he's trying to kill my bife.
Why are you going
to
let him do that?
No. Yeah.
He's making fun of you.
Rich, don't kill my bife.
No.
Let's see.
Rich, don't kill my
just
bife.
Fun texting you guys. Cool to interact. Cheers, you sexy sluts. Hashtag tequila. It's not tequila, though. This is
next week, let's
mark.
Do tequila.
Whiskey.
What? Bleh. Oh, you know what? My dad will be here in a couple weeks, and I think my dad's going to sit in with us. Greg,
mm-hmm.
Why don't we do tequila that night?
I'm down with that. We don't have a contract with them. Cheers, gentlemen. Thank you guys for hanging out. That's from Ontario, California. Thanks for being here. And any last-minute movie observation spot?
No.
There's one more movie out that might be... I don't know if it's worth checking out.
Hey, don't sweat it, man. We're so laid back on Thursday.
It's Mr. Right with Anna Kendrick.
What's your beef, dude?
What's your beef, bro?
No, seriously. Like, are you trying to like press buttons and engage? Because you're bored?
No.
It's not my problem, you're bored.
No, I'm just saying.
Go fight with someone else.
I just think you're full of shit.
Go fight with fucking Hank out in the hallway.
Here.
I just think you're full of shit.
How am I? How in the world am I full of shit?
Because you put your leg up and you sit sideways like you're like, hey, it's a fucking different vibe. Different vibe. Like, what's the difference? I do a show with you every day.
He's an angry drunk, dude. Angry drinker.
I'm not drunk.
Angry, angry drinker.
I had one glass.
Hey, dude, just because you're bored, take it out at home, not on me. I'm just talking to the people about the show.
Different.
I'm doing my job by saying, hey, here's what we do, and
Face
we
spot.
Do something else in the morning.
We do.
Hey, I'm doing your job.
We do the
why don't you do
exact
something?
Same thing in the morning.
But why are you trying to fight about it?
The exact same thing.
You, see, but you, now you're forcing like content. For what reason?
I'm not forcing content.
Bear.
I'm not.
You don't
want to
poke the bear because the bear will get more bear on you.
Relax there, Smokey, Yogi.
A good bear.
Poke the bear, see what happens.
Huh? I'm done.
Anyway.
I'm done.
Okay, Mike Tyson.
What did Mike Tyson say?
Okay, Bernstein.
No, what did Mike Tyson say in that awkward interview?
Oh,
yeah. No, that awkward interview.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, come on. Spot was like the
you
best
seem like
ever.
A really nice guy, but in fact, you're really an asshole.
But when he gets real, like, he's like,
oh, I know.
That one?
Oh, yeah.
He's like, what you going to do about it?
What you going to do about it? Remember that? Remember the guy on the TV? He's on a talk show, and the guy is like, you know what's really funny is that you act like a nice guy, but you're really an asshole.
Hey, Mike, hey, we're on live TV. Hey, calm down. Stop cursing, Mike.
What are you going to do about it?
What are you going to do about it? I love that. So anyway, Rich is trying to get a rise out of me. I won't let it happen because I'm a bigger man than that. Rich is an angry guy.
Yeah.
But anyway, thank you guys
angry
for
guy.
Hanging out.
I broke my back.
We hope you enjoy our show today. We hope you enjoy the movies this weekend. And remember, speaking of movies, The Boss, we have Ben Falcone, the writer, producer, one of the stars, Melissa
director.
McCarthy's wife, the director.
And tomorrow,
he's on
morning,
our show tomorrow morning,
a very different show. So we'll see
very
you then.
Very different. We have guests on our radio morning show. We haven't had any here
we
in
have.
The past. Yeah, who?
Dobby.
Oh, the dog, you're right.
Dobby.
Same show.
Al B.
Same show.
All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Until then, arrivederci, baby.
See you in the promised land.
Producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, Kristian Harloff, and the entire Popcorn Talk Network. We would like to thank you for tuning in. For questions or comments, be sure to visit popcorntalk.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of the Popcorn Talk Network.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of its owners or principals.